Riding with your toddler or preschooler in a child bike seat certainly is a memorable experience as a parent, but finding a bike seat that properly fits your child, your bike, and your riding style can be a challenge. Compatibility is a major issue and is the result of most negative reviews on child bike seats. That's where we come in. If you take a close look at your bike before you make your final decision, we can increase the odds that that child bike seat will fit on your bike when it arrives at your door. This guide will explain the different styles of child bike seats and help you understand if your bike is compatible with that type of seat by following our simple two-step guide. Step 1. Determine what type of child bike seat you prefer, front, rear, or mid-mount. Step 2. Check your bike for compatibility. Don't skip this step. Not every child bike seat fits on every bike. So step 1. What type of seat do you prefer? There are 3 different types of baby or child bike seats, classified by where the seat is mounted on the bike. Number 1, rear, number 2, front, and number 3, mid-mount or mountain bike seat. Starting with rear seats. Rear seats are suitable for ages 12 months to 48 pounds and are the most popular type of seat on the market. All rear seats are larger than front-mounted seats and offer more features such as the ability to recline, suspension, and shoulder straps with more adjustability. Rear seats can mount to the frame of the bike or a rack. Front seats. Front-mounted seats are the smallest seats and are suitable for ages 9 months to about 2.5 years old. Front-mounted seats mount right behind the handlebars, placing the child comfortably between the rider's arms. This position is often preferred by toddlers and parents, as it provides a snuggle factor that allows for easy communication during the ride. And last, mid-mount or mountain bike seats. Mid-mount seats are harness-free child bike seats that are suitable for ages 2 to 5. They place the child between the adult rider and the handlebars, allowing the weight of the child to be centered over the bike, promoting better balance for the adult rider. Because they do not have harnesses, the child needs to be developmentally ready to hold onto the bike themselves, rather than being strapped in. So which type of seat you choose depends on the age of your child, your style of riding, as well as the compatibility of your bike. Moving on to step 2, is your bike compatible? Each style of mounting has different requirements, which we'll cover in general. You will also want to consult the manufacturer's listing for the seat. Starting with rear frame. To determine if your bike will properly fit a rear frame mounted seat, you will need to answer 2 questions about your bike. Number 1, is your bike seat tube compatible with a child bike seat? And number 2, is your saddle or seat set too close to the frame of the bike? So first question, is your bike seat tube compatible with a child bike seat? The mounting bracket for a rear frame mounted seat attaches to the seat tube. In order to properly mount, the seat tube must usually be round, but some seats are also compatible with oval seat tubes. The seat tube needs at least 4 to 6 inches of open space, depending on how big the mounting bracket is. This open space must be clear of studs for water bottle mounts, wire mounts, and usually must be clear of all wires as well. Second question, is your saddle or seat set too close to the frame of the bike? Even if your bike's frame has the proper clearance to mount the seat, if your saddle is set within an inch of touching the bike's frame, you still may have trouble mounting a rear frame mounted seat. If your seat is set low, you might be better off using a rack mounted seat. So moving on to rear rack mounted seats. Those seats mount to a rack attached to the frame of the adult bike over the rear tire. Child bike seats typically do not come with a rack and must be purchased separately. Just be sure that any rack you use is rated to over 50 pounds of weight capacity. If your bike can take a rack, any rack-mounted child bike seat will likely work. To determine if your bike will properly fit a rear rack-mounted child bike seat, you will need to answer 2 questions about your bike. Number 1, does your bike have eyelets for mounting a rack? And number 2, does your bike have disc brakes? So question 1, does your bike have those eyelets? Without eyelets, you can't connect a rack to your bike, and so you can't mount a rear rack-mounted seat. While there are 2 sets of eyelets on the frame of a rack-compatible bike, there's 2 near the rear wheel axle and 2 near the top of the rear triangle. The top eyelets are easier to spot and essentially guarantee that those lower eyelets are on your bike. If your bike has these top eyelets, it is rack-compatible. Second question, does your bike have disc brakes? Bikes with disc brakes are only compatible with disc brake-specific bike racks, such as the Topic with disc brake mounts. Moving on to front frame. To determine if your bike will properly fit a front-mounted seat, you need to answer 2 questions about your bike. Number 1, is your bike big enough to comfortably ride with a front-mounted seat? And number 2, what type of headset does your bike have? Threaded quill or threadless A-head. Front-mounted bike seats take up about 10 inches of space between the stem and the saddle of the bike. If your top tube, which is the distance between your handlebars and the seat tube, is less than 20 inches, you will likely have difficulty riding with a front-mounted seat as your chest and knees may both hit the seat. Second question, what type of headset does your bike have? Threaded or threadless? Bikes with quill stems, also called threaded headsets, are generally very compatible with bike seat mounts. On quill stems, the mounting bracket is clamped around the stem. Mounting brackets range from about 1/2 inch to 1.5 inches tall, so you will need that amount of open space on your stem. The second type of headset is threadless or A-head. Threadless headsets are much more challenging to fit with front-mounted bike seats, but there are a few seats that offer threadless adapters to fit into the tighter spaces available on these headsets. Take a look at the Thule Yet Mini or the Haymax Observer if this applies to you. In general, front-mounted seats are not compatible with mountain bikes, but are better suited for fitness, hybrid, and comfort bikes. And what about mid-mount or mountain bike seats? Mid-mount seats are much easier to fit on a bike than rear and traditional front-mounted seats. If you're interested in an MTB seat, our favorites are MacRide, Kids Ride Shotgun, Doolittle, and Tike Toter. Thanks for watching and happy riding!